Hi there, welcome to 1.1 Data Representation by Cambridge International AS and A-Level Computer Science. So first of all, let's go into number system. So any number system always has a base. It can be base 10 binary. So this is the normal number that we normally use in our daily life, such as 5, 10, 20, 15, or any other random number. And it can be base 2 binary, or it can be base 16 hexadecimal. So we'll be going through base 2 and base 16 in this lecture itself. So let's look at this. Computer system always use binary system, which only allow either 1 or 0, and each of the binary digits are known as bits. So you can think of it, this 1 or 0 is actually known as bits, and most data is actually stored as 8-bit patterns, which is called bytes. So for the time being, just remember that 8 bits actually stand for 1 byte. So let's look into binary number system. We normally use base 10, as I mentioned, or decimal binary number system, such as 1, 10, 100, 1000, 50, or any other random number. But binary actually uses base 2 number system with possible bits of either 1, 0 or 1, which I actually talked about it in the previous slide. So let's look at this from the right to the left. So if you look at this, this is the unit and this is the possible bits. So we always start from 2 to the power 0, 7 for 1, 2 to the power 1, 7 for 2, 2 to the power square, 10 for 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, and 1 to 8. And as I say, we can only represent this either in 0 or 1. So for each of the bits, it's actually, we can only either represent using 0 or 1. So if you use 0, it means that it doesn't exist, and if it's 1, it means that it's present. So let's look into one example. Let's convert binary number 11110001 to decimal or binary number here. So this is how you do it. First of all, this 1 stands for 128 here, which is the 8 bit, and then this 1 stands for 64 and etc. Yeah. So it will be 1 times 128, which is this for this one, and 1 times 64, which is for this one, and 1 times 32 is for this one, and 1 times 16, and then 0 times 8. So normally what I'm going to do is that I actually don't include this step when I do 0 times 8, 0 times 4, 0 times 2. Normally I will just exclude this step itself, but for demo sake I will just show here. But you know, in fact in your exam you actually can just skip the 0 times 8, 0 times 4 or 0 times 2, and finally just do 1 times 1. And in the end what I'm going to do here is that I'm just going to sum all of the numbers together and we get 241. So in a nutshell, what it means is that this binary number actually represents 241 here. So let's look into hexadecimal number system. So hexadecimal uses base 16 number system with 16 possible single characters from 0 to F. So let's look into this table again. So we have 0 here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So if you look at this table itself, I actually crossed out 10 to 15. The reason why is that because it mentioned that it can only be single character. So 10 is actually double character. So what we're going to do here is that we're just going to replace 10 with A. So be A stand for 10, B stand for 11, C stand for 12, D stand for 13, and E stand for 14, and F stand for 15. Yeah. So what is hexadecimal being used in? Actually used in color code representation, for example blue, and then we do the hash 00FFFFF. It means that for this hexadecimal number actually represent blue color. Or we can do in program code to represent Unicode character. So we'll be covering Unicode character in the later chapter. So let's look at this. Let's say lambda actually stands for this 03BB in terms of hexadecimal number system. And we actually use this in assembly language and machine code, which we will cover in the later chapters. Yeah. So let's look at the tables for hexadecimal number system. So we have 16 to the power 0, 16 to the power 1, 16 to the power square, 16 to the power cube. Definitely we still have 16 power 4 to 5, 6, 7, 8, but definitely since this exam itself it actually doesn't allow you to use calculator, so definitely you can just remember up to power of 3 is more than enough. And definitely for the possible character, as what we covered in the previous slide, definitely you only can use 0 all the way to F. We can't use like 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. We can use like A represent 10 and etc. So let's do an example right now. Let's convert hexadecimal 2AB216 to binary number. So what we do here is 2, first of all you times 496. This 496 stands for 16 to the power of cube. So and then 10 stands for A, so it'll be 25 times 256. B stands for 11, so 11 times 16. And 2 just 10 to the power of 1, so it's 2 times 1. And the sum will be 10930. So what it means is that 2AB2 in hexadecimal form actually represent 10930 in this case here. So this is part of the content covered in Cambridge International AS and A-Level Computer Science. If you are interested in the upcoming launch of the full online course into AS and A-Level Computer Science, definitely just click on the link below to get notified as soon as the course is ready to get early bird discount. Or you can just subscribe to this channel, which I will post the announcement later as well. Thank you, and I will see you again then. Bye bye.